So my name is Brian Roberts. I'm the head robotic technologist here at the Goddard Spaceflight Center. Today we're going to take a tour of the ROC, or the Robotic Operations Center. As you enter the ROC, you see a room that's a little bit smaller than a gymnasium at a school. You'll notice that the walls are all black, and that's to simulate the darkness of space, so we can shut the lights out in the room, and the robots will be in an environment that will be as dark as it is in space. So just like sports teams practice before they play a game, we practice with robots as well. The first robot you'll hear is our engineering unit of the eventual robot that will fly in space. And the reason we build that is so we can work out all the details of how to put the robot together and make sure it works before we build the more expensive flight unit. So the sound you hear sounds like hail hitting a tin roof. What you'll hear is the brakes on the robot coming on and off, moving back and forth, and you kind of hear a tinging sound as these seven pieces of metal are hitting each other. This robot is a hexapod, which is a motion platform on which we mount a satellite mock-up, and the robot then moves that mock-up, simulating its motion as it would be moving through space. What you'll hear are the motors moving back and forth, and it kind of sounds like a car engine revving up and revving down as you push the gas pedal and get more acceleration, less acceleration. You'll hear those motors moving the six legs of the robot up and down, back and forth in front of the robot. The last robot you'll hear is an industrial robot that's used by car companies and other factories to assemble furniture, or assemble cars or paint cars. So this robot is about the size of a human, maybe 6 feet or so, and it's got 7 degrees of freedom, so seven individual actuators that move. And what you'll hear is it moving through our facility, and much like the previous robot, you'll hear the motors kind of revving up and revving down. Thank you for spending some time today touring our robotic operations facility and listening to some of the robots that we use to simulate robots working in space.